Okay, now we test the example with the one interrupt, and now we can test the hands-on with the multiple interrupts. But we have only one button, then don't worry, I will show you how it will override the settings and we use the more buttons or the more inputs. Then I will start the new project. And our goal will be here to use the two inputs with the interrupts. One input we turn, for example, the button will turn the LED on, and the second button will turn the LED off. Then here I select again the F4, the line F401. The package will be LQFP64, and I have the 512 kilobyte device. It's the STM32F401 RED. This one, click on OK. Now, like in the previous case, I will mark the LED, which is the PA5, as you know. I will set it as an output. Then I will use the PC13 again as a input with the interrupt, which we build here the XT13. And then I select the additional input. In my case, I don't have any other buttons. Then I will do the trick. I will select one unconnect pin. For example, here I will use the PA0. In your case, you can use, for example, the different pin if you want. But I will use the PA0 because I know that this pin is unconnected. You can use also the wire, which can be connected to the 5-volt or 3.3-volt or 0. But I will use this pin. I will set it also as a XT. Okay. Then I have two XT pins and one LED. One pin will turn the LED on, second pin will turn the LED off. I think this is okay. Now I will go to the clock configuration. Here it's not necessary to change anything. And I will here go to the configuration. I look into the GPIOs. I look on the PA0. It will be on the rising edge because I don't have any pull up or pull down, and I don't want to use even the cable, for example, which will connect the pin with the 3.3 volt or ground. I don't care about the rising or falling edge. This I will explain you a little bit later. But the PC13, I need again to change to the extra interrupt mode with falling edge. PA5, it's okay. Now again, I need to check the XT. Today I will not use the delay, then I can left here the preemption varieties on 0. But here I need to enable the XT0 and XT1. Please don't forget to enable the interrupts in the NVIC, otherwise the interrupt will not work. Never. Okay, I can save my project. I will name it two, and today now I will use the IR, for example, is the IDE. Okay, now I can look into my main.c. You can see initialization is still the same, HL init, system call config, and GPIO init. In the GPIO init, we can find all our pins and also all our two reset interrupt vectors. And also I can find here, there here will be not only xt 10 to 15, but also xt xt to 0. Both handled with the HL EERQ EERQ handler. Then for both I need now create my callback. Like before, I will use the drivers. I will use the GPL and I will simply search for the underscore underscore week. Yes, I will copy this complete function without week, of course, and I put it here into above my main, in my case. Okay. And now I have only one callback, but I have multiple interrupts. Then how to discover which interrupts trigger this callback? Then for this I have here one input parameter, which is the pin which triggers this interrupt. Then I here put put here the if, and I here put the check. If this pin was pin underscore 0, if this pin was 0, then HLGPL underscore write pin GPIOA, I have the let GPIO underscore pin underscore 5, and the state is GPIO pin underscore reset to switch the pin off, and I detect the edge on the pin 0. And if this GPIO pin is equal to GPIO pin underscore 13, then HL underscore GPIO underscore write pin GPIOA pin underscore 5 GPIO pin underscore set to turn the pin on. Okay, I can try to compile my code. What this will do when I have the callback from the interrupt on the pin 0, I switch the LED off. When I detect that the source of this callback is pin 13, I switch this pin on. Okay, maybe you are asking why if this pin which triggers this callback is on different port. On the XT periphery, you can have only the sources for the interrupts for pin 0 to pin 13. But you need to select which port will be the source. You cannot have the PA0 and PB0, but you can have the PA0 and PB1. This is allowed, but you cannot have two pin zeros on the different port as the clock, so as the source of the external interrupt. Then don't be careful on this. Okay, I have everything. I can run my debug. Okay, I can run the code here with this button or F5. I can press the button and the LED is blinking. Now how to turn off the LED? I can slide over the pins on my nucleus on the left side. And because this pin is floating, we talk about it, that is very dangerous to let the pin floating. Then if I slide over all these pins on the left header, I will charge the pin or discharge the pin, depend how charged I am. and I will create the noise on the pin, and I change the state of the pin, and I create the rising or the falling edge. This is the reason why you need always to set this unconnected pin as the analog, or connect these pins to the ground or VDD, because all the pins which are left unconnected can detect the change of these pins. In my case, that I slide over these pins. In the low power application, this will rapidly increase the consumption of complete application. In case that you target the microamps, the floating pin which is left unconnected will be a huge amount of the current, because the internal structure of the pin is still working and everything is detected, even the noise. And be careful on this. Please do not try this on the carpet, which charge you with very, very high very high charge. Okay, then this is the how to handle two pin interrupts. In case that you want to use the three, you only here put the more ifs and you handle the additional pin. This is everything from this part.